Welcome dear students in our YouTube channel technofun.kvs. In this video we have to learn about the Python which we have already completed in class 7th, because to further work in Python in class 8th and to get expertise and mastery on it, first of all this is very essential to have a recap of Python which we have completed in class 7th. So let us move ahead. First of all, as we know, Python is a programming language, and before this we need to understand that what is a programming. So as you can see on the screen, programming is the process of writing codes instructions in a programming language to resolve some problem, create games, develop software and create website, etc. Or in other words, what we want to make computer to do, we can make some program for it, we can make for some software for it, and the art of making programs or software is called programming. And Python is very easy to understand, very interactive in manner, and have various simple instructions so that we can make our programs very easily. Now before making any program, we need to understand that how we have to make a program, means the step-by-step approach we need to create a particular software. So that is why we have the concept of here algorithm. Now algorithm is very important for any software to have a great quality. Algorithm is the process of writing all the steps required to solve a particular problem. These steps can be written in any language we can understand. To develop an algorithm, following steps are required. First, read problem definition, means we need to clear that what is the problem, for what problem we are going to make a software. So second thing is we have to analyze the problem to identify input, output and process. As soon as we have find the problem, we have to see and find, analyze that what are the possible inputs we have, what are the processes we have, and what are their outcomes or the outputs. Now we will develop an algorithm, means the step-by-step procedure. In step number 4, refine by adding more details. If we have to see, check whether we have to refine our details, then we can refine it in our step number 4. And finally, in the last step, we will review the developed algorithm, whether it is okay for the solution of our problem or not. So algorithm is a step-by-step approach in which we make or list out the steps of the logic we need to make our software. Now in this series, we have another concept of flowchart. Flowchart is a pictorial representation of the steps involved in the solution of the problem, or we can say in the above discussed algorithm. Algorithm is the step-by-step procedure which we just write on a piece of paper. But flowchart is a diagrammatic representation of the data flow from the input, from the start to input, process, and if any decisions we have, then we will select this box. If we have the flow lines, we can use these flow lines here, and these are the connector. So basically, to identify a particular algorithm pictorially or diagrammatically so that the programmer or the user can understand that what is going to be happen in the algorithm, or whether our algorithm is executing correctly or not. So we have the help of our flowchart. It's a very useful tool to identify the correctness and the accuracy of our algorithm. Now what are the advantages of flowchart? As you can see on the screen, we have the first and most important advantage, improved communication, because we know how and from where the data is moving, communicating from one point to the another point in our software. Second, visual clarity. We need to understand that from which point data is going and is coming correct or not. In the third, effective analysis. Fourth, problem solving. Fifth, documentation. So these are the various advantages of a flowchart. Therefore, we always, as a good programmer, we have a practice of making flowchart of our algorithm before starting actual coding of our software. Now, as we are selecting and working here in Python programming language, as it is very easy, free, open source programming language, so we need to understand its features. Python is developed by, created by Guido van Rossum in December 1989. The language name is not about snakes, but its name was picked from British comedy troupe Monty Python's Flying Circus. Guido van Rossum is a big fan of Monty Python's Flying Circus. Python is used by many big companies like NASA, Google, Nokia, IBM, Netflix, Facebook, Yahoo Maps, etc. That is why, as we have already discussed, that it is very useful, easy, interactive, and free open source language. So that is why it is popular. So what are the features of Python? As we have discussed, Python is popular. Is interpreted means it is a interpreted programming language. As we have learned in class 7th, that we have some language translators like compiler, interpreter, and assembler. So Python is an interpreted language, means it will convert line by line, step by step, instruction by instruction, rather in as we have in compiler, in a single step. So it is a little bit slower also. Python is free, as we have said, open source programming language. Anyone can download from internet. Python is portable. That means the programs which we make, develop using Python can run on any kind of operating system. So it is very portable and very good. Feature 5, Python is easy to learn and use. Yes, it is very, very interactive and supports GUI programming. So we have some these features of the Python which make it very famous and popular among the programmers and the developers. So we have discussed some brief introduction about the Python programming language. In our next videos, we will discuss about the variables, data types, and keywords, and much more. So thank you all of you for watching this video on the recap of Python. Thank you.